Hi! Today we are going to show you how to drain the oil and change the transmission filter in the automatic gearbox of your Volkswagen Golf 7. Over these years, there has been an ongoing debate about whether or not this type of operation was worthwhile, but let's make it clear. Just as you would expect to change the engine oil to ensure a proper lubrication of moving parts, in your vehicle it is absolutely essential to change the gearbox oil and transmission filter on a regular basis. This is essential to keep your automatic gearbox in good working order and, above all, to make it last over time. We will tell you all about it in this video.
You can find out more about the exclusive new range of Perflex basic kit transmission filters needed to change the oil in your car automatic gearbox in the video description. Before changing the oil in your automatic gearbox, start your vehicle and using a diagnostic kit, check that the gearbox oil has reached a temperature between 35 and 45 degrees Celsius. This will allow the oil to be more fluid when changing it, and with a temperature closer to the values required for checking and reaching the right level. Once you've reached the proper temperature, switch off your car. Apply the handbrake, pull the bonnet release handle and open the bonnet. To access the transmission filter, the airbox and the battery must be removed. Using a screwdriver and a Torx T25 bit, unscrew the two screws holding the air intake cover in place. Remove the cover. Unclip the cooling hose from its housing. Then unclip and remove the plastic pipe. Disconnect the vacuum hose from the airbox. Then disconnect the airflow meter connector. Now use Cable-tie-pliers to shift the air intake duct clamp. Disconnect the duct from the airbox and remove the airbox from its housing. Now you need to remove the battery. Open the battery textile cover. Never start by disconnecting the positive terminal as the whole car is connected to the negative terminal. This may create sparks that could damage your car's electrical system. Using a 10mm open-end spanner, start by removing the negative lug. When you remove it from the terminal, remember to pull the cable away to prevent it from being reconnected accidentally, as this could damage your vehicle's electrical system. Repeat the operation in the positive lug. Now remove the battery textile cover. To remove the battery, you must unscrew the retaining plate. Using a ratchet, a large extension lead and a 13mm socket, completely unscrew the bolt securing the metal retaining plate. Now, you can remove the battery. Unclip the cables from the battery tray. Using a ratchet and a 10mm socket, unscrew the three screws holding the battery tray in place. Now, you can remove the battery tray. Now you have access to the bell housing of the transmission filter. Using a ratchet, a long extension and a 24mm socket, unlock the transmission filter cover by turning it counterclockwise until it turns easily. Finish unscrewing by hand. Place it in a container for liquid recovery. Remove the transmission filter. For this operation, we strongly recommend using an automatic gearbox oil change machine, which, unlike other methods, will replace all the used oil and clean the oil circuit in a perfect way. Take the new adapter supplied with the machine and screw it into the transmission filter holder. Finish screwing with a ratchet and a 12mm Allen bit. Once properly assembled, connect the two oil hoses of the machine to the adapter. When the adapter is connected to the machine, The battery must be roughly put back in place together with the airbox so that the vehicle can be started for oil change operations with the machine. Next, you need to implement the procedure using the machine, which will have to be carried out with the engine running. The machine will collect the used oil and at the same time inject the same quantity of new oil. This is an automatic procedure. Just follow the instructions of the machine. At the end of the procedure, you're asked to add a certain amount of oil, which allows the proper level to be slightly exceeded. It will then be adjusted during the level check procedure. Once the machine procedure has been complete, the airbox and the battery must be removed again to be able to reach the transmission filter once more. Disconnect the hoses from the adapter, then unscrew the adapter. Puflux has developed a wide range of transmission filters with all the components needed for their installation. Clean the filter cover with brake cleaner and a cloth. Using a thin flathead screwdriver, remove the rubber O-ring from the underside of the cover flange. Replace the O-ring with the one supplied in the box with the new filter, taking care to oil the surface thoroughly. Take the new Perflex transmission filter and insert it into the filter holder. Screw the cover back on by hand until it touches. To tighten it, use the ratchet and the 24mm socket. Finish tightening with the Torx spanner set to 25Nm. Now you can put permanently back in place the battery tray, the battery, the airbox, the air intake cover. To top up the gearbox oil in your vehicle, you need to lift the car front and rear so that it's flat for you to reach and check the right level, as well as to access the gearbox drain plug. Lift the front and rear of your vehicle. We strongly advise you to watch our tutorial, Lifting Your Vehicle Safely, before carrying out this step. Place the vehicle on the four jack stands. You can then remove the plastic splash shield, if any, to be able to reach the gearbox oil drain plug. Before setting the right oil level, you need to start the vehicle and operate the lever several times so that all the components in the system can be filled with oil. Turn off the air conditioning and all the electrical components. Press the brake pedal. Then slowly move the gear lever into all the positions. Make sure that all the speeds have been selected. Then move the gear lever to the park position. Then, using the diagnostic kit, make sure that the gearbox oil has reached a temperature between 35 and 45 degrees Celsius, which corresponds to the oil fluidity temperature required to reach and check the level. Switch off your vehicle. Place the oil recovery container under the gearbox. Then, using a ratchet and a 14mm Allen bit, unscrew the gearbox drain plug. At the plug outlet, the oil sump is fitted with a tube that runs back into the sump, which allows the oil level to be checked. When the oil level is above the tube inlet, the oil flows steadily. You need to wait for the oil to start dripping continuously, which means that the oil level in the sump has reached the tube inlet corresponding to the proper oil level. Replace the drain plug with a new one, then screw the plug back in by hand initially, before the final tightening with the tool without overdoing it. Finish tightening with the Torx spanner. Refit the splash shield, then screw it back on. You can now put your vehicle back on the ground. Operation completed.